Hi guys, are you facing the problems for pH settings in bioanalysis or pathological laboratory? Here in this video, I will solve all your queries regarding for pH setting. Hi guys, welcome to my YouTube channel. In this video, we will see how to set the urea kit in every semi bioanalyzer. Before proceeding for the urea kit settings, I will show its clinical significance and why doctors prefer to diagnose the urea test. As urea flows from our liver to our kidney through our bloodstream, healthy kidney filters urea and removes other waste products from our blood. The filtered waste products leaves from our blood through urine. Increased levels of urea in blood is called as uremia, which is by intake of diet with excess of proteins, which affects for the renal disease, renal obstructions and heart failure. The symptoms is dry skin, brittle nails, heart function, palpitations, muscle weakness, bone pain, shortness of breath, increase of blood pressure, nausea, constipation, etc. And the normal range of the urea is 15 to 50 mg per dl. Now we will proceed for the kit settings of the semi-bioanalyzers by the manufacturer Perfexn. Switch on this bioanalyzer before 10 minutes to perform the test so that all the software program will be set in the analyzer. Here on the screen you will see the top menu options are there. According to the literature provided by the manufacturer, here I am showing over there. We will set for the urea kit setting. Go for the test option over here. Go in the open channel. Edit for the name to which test to be performed. Edit the option for go for the parameters, go in the basic. Here you will see the test options is there, so we have to edit by backspace. Enter the name urea for the blank, as it is a fixed time method, it has no blank. Go for the urea test. Here on the literature you will see units is mg per dl, so go for the mg per dl. For the reagent volume, on the literature you will see the reagent volume is 1 ml. I am performing the test by in the half ratio, so I will enter for the 500 microliter. Go for the sample volume. Here on the literature you will see the sample volume is 10 micro for 1 ml. I am performing for the half ratio, so it will come up to 5 microliter. And the expression volume will be 450 only. For the factor, we will do the calibration for that. Automatically it will be set for that. Go for the test mode. The test mode, it is here you will see the reaction mode. This is for the fixed time. So enter for the fixed time. For the parameter setting, you will see on the literature it is 340 nanometer. So enter for that. For the temperature requirement for to carry out the test is 37 degrees Celsius on the literature. So enter for the 37 degrees Celsius. For the delay time, you will see on the literature it is 30 seconds. So enter for the 30 seconds. And for the wait time, here you will see the wait time is 60 seconds. So enter for the 60 seconds. Say all these options accordingly we have set by the literature. Go in the main button. Go for the calibration. So we have to enter the value of the urea. Here of the standard value concentration is 40 mg. So enter for the concentration of 40 mg. Save it and run for the test. We are performing the test of urea by the GLDH method mentioned upon the literature you will see. The manufacturer have given the linearity over here, that is 300 mg per dl of its reagent. Before proceeding for the test, show you the requirements to carry out the test. We require the valuable pipettes of 100 to 4000 microliter and 5 to 50 microliter. Here you will see the clean and dry tips for its pipettes, the clean and dry test tubes, tissue paper, reagent kit, the sample. I am working with the bioread control level 1 and the distilled water. Yes, in the half ratio. So the working solution to prepare for the half ratio is 4:1. So adjust the micropipette with 400 of reagent to carry out to take the volume of R1. The reagent should be taken without air bubble to get a better result. I have taken 400 microliters of R1 in each tube tube. So I have to always have to carry out for the standard for the calibration and one for the taste. And for the R2 is a substrate reagent. You will see on this. Take substrate reagent of 100 microliter without air bubble and place it in the R1 reagent or in the tube. Close it tightly to avoid contamination. On the screen you will see they have told for the aspiration for distilled water, aspirate for distilled water. Here we have to do the calibration for this. So press for the calibration menu. Here I am taking the urea standard of 40 mg, you will see over here. Take the volume of 5 micro, wipe the excess and mix in the working solution of R1 and R2. Mix it well and aspirate immediately. Note down the initial OD, that is 1.591, and the graph is in the decreasing phase. Here on the screen you will see the absorbance of the standard is 0.046 and the factor is 864.51. So it's OK. So press for the OK option. Now we will have to aspirate for the sample. Previously I told you that I have taken the pyrite control sample of level 1. Here you will see level 1 pyrite control. Wipe the excess amount of sample. Mix in the working solution of R1 and R2. Mix well and aspirate immediately. Note down the initial OD, it is 1.651 and the graph is in the decreasing curve. Here on the screen you will see the result is 33.40. So here I will show the pyrite control sheet by which we have performed this test. This is the urea. This is the target range for this is 33.2 target is value and 28.5 to 37.9 is target range. And our result have come to the target value, it is 33.4. As our result is in the target value, so here the result reagents taken from the Perfexn, which is giving the best result with an authentic value. We have learned from this video for the urea clinical significance, symptoms, kit settings in semi-bioanalyzer, procedure for the urea test, etc. So here, if you like the videos, please the like button, subscribe this channel and share with others. For more upcoming video, hit the bell icon. For any query, drop in the comment box.